Rubio, where are your kids? Have you sent them to vocational school, or have you put them into the best college you can get if you have any kids, or where are you planning to put them? They all want a flat tax. A flat tax is a bonanza, a windfall for rich parasites. That's all it is. It's simple. Carly Fiorina says that she's going to boil the tax code down to 3 pages. Man, that must be micro writing, right? If she can put it all, maybe she can put it all on the head of a pin. But the outcome is going to be that the tax bill for the oligarchs is going to go down. Also with Trump. Trump says, I'm going to take away carried interest. Carried interest loophole is worth about $2 billion to Wall Street. But he's going to reward them with no estate tax, no oligarch tax, right? When those oligarchs shuffle off this mortal coil, that's when you could get one last chance to soak them. But no. And that's worth $20 billion. So Trump taketh away $2 billion and giveth $20 billion. He's a friend of the oligarchs. The carried interest is simply a cover story. Back in a minute on World Crisis Radio. Welcome back to World Crisis Radio. We are very happy now to go to Damascus, Syria, to get another report from our distinguished friend there, Thierry Maison of the Voltaire Network. And we've essentially got 3 items on the table. One is what's happening militarily on the ground. Secondly, the U.S. Actions together with the Kurds. What does that mean about the overall strategy by the U.S. in particular? And thirdly, there are now these Vienna talks, which have taken place again today. Do we get anything out of that? So, Thierry, welcome. And why don't you start with the first point?
Yes, the first question is about the military action inside Syria. So at the first phase of the Russian bombing in Syria, we have seen a lot of jihadists going away. But of course, there was no change in the lines of the fighting. And right now is the second phase in the fight. With the action on the ground by the Arab Syrian army. So right now we can see that the jihadists are losing the ground in Aleppo and near Palmyra. So of course the army needs 1 or 2 months to fight out the jihadists from these 2 cities, but it's clearly going now, and we can hope for the victory in January, something like that. That's okay. The first point. The second point is about the Kurds. If you remember, in 2013. The New York Times published a new map for the reshaping of the Middle East in an article signed by Robin Wright. At that time, the journalist was working for the Pentagon. And according to this map, Daesh will be created to make a Sulistan in Al-Anbar district in Iraq, and in the Syrian desert. And also, according to this map, they have to create a Kurdistan in the north of Syria, but unfortunately this part of Syria is without Kurds. there is only 30% of the people in this part of Syria who were Kurds at that time. And so right now, the U.S., Israel, and France together launched a new attack in the north of Syria with the Kurdish Syrians to conquer this part of Syria and create a new Kurdistan. So this is very strange because it means that the Kurdish party of the Washington side, it's very surprising because they want to create a kind of colonial state in the north of Syria, but until now, this Kurdish party was a Marxist-Leninist one, and it's surprising to see they are now with a colonial project. So, because of that, you are at the same time in Iraq, the U.S. and the Kurds from Iraq fighting together in the Sinjar Mountain against the against Daesh, against the Islamic State. So, if you remember, since 1 year and a half, neither the U.S. was really fighting against the Islamic State, except since the 14 July, when they signed the agreement with Iran, and 2 weeks later, they bombed the Islamic State in Hasake, Syria. It was the first action, the first real action of the coalition against Daesh. After 1 year, during then they support Daesh, not they don't fight against him.
Right.
So the result of this action is that right now all the Christians in the north of Syria are making a new coalition against the Kurds, because of course, they will not accept to be governed by the Kurds like that. And right now, the Kurdish party entering the schools in the north of Syria, they expel the teachers, and they put new teachers from Kurdish origin, but we don't know exactly from where they are going, if they are Syrian, Turks, or Iraqis. And they began a new teaching only in Kurdish language, no more in Arabic. And the first thing we have to see, the first thing is about the negotiation in Vienna. If you remember, it was decided that the United Nations will organize four different groups with people from the opposition and people from the Syrian government, and they will have some talks about the future of Syria. In fact, the idea was to know exactly the position of the two groups and to make report to the member of the Security Council. It was not a negotiation. It was a kind of pool, in fact, to know exactly how the Syrian government and its opposition, its multiple opposition, can accept or refuse different proposals. But they changed this plan. And right now, it seems that in Vienna, they will have only two groups, and they will negotiate for the future of Syria, and especially they will negotiate who will be responsible to vote a new constitution. I think this is a very bad news because, as you know, always the problem in democracy is who is writing the constitution, and if
Terry, hold that thought. We'll get you back in the next segment. If you can hang on for a minute or two, we'll be right back and you can complete that. And maybe I can ask you one or two things, okay? Back in a minute on World Crisis Radio. Welcome back to World Crisis Radio. We are talking with Terry Maison in Damascus, Syria, keeping up with this fast-moving situation. Now, Terry, you were saying that the Vienna talks have taken a wrong turn, and that we've got two groups are going to try to produce a new constitution. When you say two groups, does that mean two groups from inside Syria?
No, it looks that the main powers want to first make a list of the leaders of the opposition who will negotiate the constitution with government. But if they succeed to have this clip, it means that the constitution will be right half by the opposition, half by the government. Of course, this is nonsense. And the only way to write a constitution is to have a special assembly for that, elected by all the citizens. But of course, the U.S. will not accept that, because if there is a constitutional assembly, certainly this assembly will reject the idea of a Muslim society, but this assembly will have a secular constitution. But if we have this system with half and half, the constitution will be a compromise, not at all something, not at all a project for the country, but a way to help foreign states to have their hand in this country. So I'm afraid because of this evolution, but fortunately, today, there was a clash between John Kerry and Sergei Lavrov. It seems that John Kerry invites new states to this negotiation in Vienna without consulting Sergei Lavrov. So it means that the U.S. tried to push to change the composition of the negotiators in Vienna to be sure that they will choose the good opposition according to them. So I mean the opposition linked to Washington and to NATO.
Right. In other words, the moderate terrorists. Well, so it sounds like the danger
is
that...
the moderate terrorists, exactly. The moderate terrorists. This is the...
And the danger is therefore a rotten compromise that would lead to a weak state and to Syria continuing as the plaything of foreign powers, right, rather than asserting independence.
Yes, but you know, there is no solution in Syria if there is always an option for the Muslim Brotherhood to enter in this country. Since 1978... the Muslim Brotherhood tried to reverse the secular regime here. And you know that in 1978 they made a lot of attacks in this country until 1982, when they tried to perform a coup d'etat against the Syrian Arab Republic. And this ended in a big fight in Hama. And right now, the Muslim Brotherhood again is the big organizer on the ground of the fight with the support of the U.S. So if this continues, we will never have the peace in Syria.
Okay. Thierry, thank you very much. It's always very illuminating. I hope we can get you back next week. Things are moving fast,
okay.
And we'll be looking forward to hearing from you again. Thank you very much.
Okay. See you. Goodbye.
So that was Thierry Meyssan of the Voltaire Network speaking from Damascus, Syria, and the most up-to-date and the most insightful that you're going to find anywhere. So thanks again to Thierry. Now, our time is dwindling. We got to catch up with these Republicans, right? The crimes of the Republicans have somehow become overwhelming. I actually heard that some people said, oh, these Republicans are better. Anybody who thinks the Republicans are a viable alternative better get their head examined right away. Trump is not a populist. Trump is a plutocrat. Carson is mentally unstable. Rubio is simply a demagogue, right? A typical lying politician. Rubio is telling you can't go to college. The other thing is all the laws have been suspended, right? When, for example, Perry, the last time around, Perry said he